My name is Renzo Cataldo. I'm a cardiac electrophysiologist and I presently live in Phoenix, Arizona. I think I first wanted to be a doctor when I went to see an eye doctor when I was in the third grade, and my dad took me there, and I thought that this would be the coolest thing in the world to do, just to see people and try to help them along. So I am a cardiac electrophysiologist, and a cardiac electrophysiologist sounds like blah, 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 lots of, you know, gobbledygook cardiac electrophysiologist. But essentially, you know, the way I see it is the heart is like a house, all right? There's rooms, there's doors, there's electricity, and there's plumbing, right? And I am the electrician. So I deal with heart rhythm disturbances. So I really want to be able to take care of patients as part of a team that is completely comprehensive. Here in the greater Phoenix market, but specifically with Biltmore Cardiology on the west side in particular, we're growing. We have a whole team of interventional cardiologists, which are the plumbers. We have surgeons. We have top-notch, very advanced imaging, and then I'm going to try to bring my specialty there to help take care of the need for that growing part of town. My philosophy is this: when I was at a previous employer and they asked me, "Hey, you need to see more patients because you chat too much," and I'd say, "No. What's more important to me is how is my patient's experience going to be?" So people really need to be educated first and put sort of at a certain ease. And then, you know, the fact that I have a couple of gray hairs on my head is important for some patients, at least. To say, hey, this guy, you know, has done this once or twice before. There was a young woman who essentially was having all kinds of heart rhythm problems. So I really went, you know, a little bit further with her, with one of my excellent pacemaker technicians, and having her pacemaker dialed in just right. And eventually she wound up doing great. And then she came to the office a few months later and I said, "Hey, what's going on? I just saw you recently." She said, "I wanted to bring you a picture." And she showed me a picture of an ultrasound and she was having a baby. And she said, "If this is a boy, we want to name him Renzo." And that brought me to tears. And that is really why I went into medicine.